Hey guys, so recently I decided I was going to do a camera review. Now I'm going to be reviewing the Nikon Z6 when we have one in the lab. I'm going to take the lead on that. But I wanted to practice and I wanted to get ready to do my first big full-scale review. So I picked this Nikon D70 off the shelf, old school vintage DSLR. In fact, one of the first consumer level commercially available DSLRs that you could get. In fact, the control scheme really is the control scheme that's used on a lot of Nikon DSLRs in recent years. It was a much better control scheme than its predecessor, the D100, and it was very similar to the D50, which came out shortly after. So I was originally going to make it a really funny review. In fact, here's some footage from that review that I was putting together. The Nikon D70 is the absolute best digital SLR camera that 2004 had to offer. Folks, leave your film at home or find entirely new uses for it, because this camera embraces digital technology. In fact, your images will have 6 million pixels and really come to life on your modular desktop home computer system. Even in 2018, the D70 holds up extremely well compared to current offerings, unless pixel count, dynamic range, high ISO performance, frames per second, video, or a crisp, clear LCD are important to you. And just look at this LCD screen. It's nearly 2 inches in size. That's smaller than anything today. But it really helps you focus on what's important, getting that next shot rather than looking back at that last crappy shot that you took. There's no video on this baby. Frankly, I've seen your home videos. I really have. And well, stick to stunning 6-megapixel still images, please. The menus are simple and concise. There's hardly anything you can change anyway. Again, get that next shot, worry about picture controls and white balance some other time. You do have a great control scheme here, still in use by many cameras today. Along the left side of the camera's rear are controls for ISO, white balance, and picture quality. Use these in conjunction with the rear command dial, and you're set. With the whole D70 package, when someone goes running by, you're always ready to stalk them at 3 blistering and stealthy frames per second. Now, some of you are rolling your eyes and thinking, that camera has a mirror. It's 2018. We want mirrorless in 2018. Well, let me tell you a big secret. The manufacturers are taking the mirrors out of the camera, but they're also raising prices. They should put a mirror in the damn box anyway, just so you get your money's worth. Face it, when they sell you a mirrorless camera, they're ripping you off. Don't get ripped off. Get the Nikon D70. Really, what I ended up doing in the review was mocking the camera. Now, what I also needed to do, though, was go out and chew with it, not just talk about it. Obviously, it doesn't hold up very well with its 6-megapixel sensor. Tremendous inefficiencies compared to what you can do today, and far fewer features. What was very interesting about that, when I actually took it out to get test images for the review, I enjoyed it. It was a good time. It's very simple. I wasn't buried in menus. I wasn't buried in the LCD screen. It's too small to get buried in, and there's only a few options. The shooting menu's like one screen, and it's a small screen. And I was really mindfully brought in to what I was shooting. It's not a whole lot like using a computer like a lot of cameras are today. It doesn't have a touch screen. It doesn't have all those fancy features that I love having. But then I'm in the camera, not necessarily in the moment. The LCD, the old school LCD, even tricks you into thinking that you have less dynamic range than you have. But then when I was over in Nikon Capture, I was certainly finding weaknesses in the shadows and as I tried to pull them up in some circumstances. But I also asked myself, well, why am I compensating for what I didn't get in the camera? In other words, why am I having to lean so heavily in some of my photos on the dynamic range? Was it due to limitations of the camera, or did I not get the shot in the moment the way that I wanted to? What I've found is the shots that would be good shots with the latest cameras were good shots with the D70, and the shots that didn't do anything for me wasn't the D70 that had anything to do with it. It was me and the way I composed it and the way that I thought it was going to look later on, but you know, then I realized, well, maybe I should have moved over here. The light wasn't coming in quite the way that I wanted to, and I was anxious to get the shot and move on to the next one. So anyway, I won't hold you today, but I learned a little bit of a lesson while putting that review together and trying to be funny and maybe even make fun of this old camera a little bit is there's nothing to make fun of here. It delivers the same way that it did over 10 years ago when it released. And as long as this thing keeps working, it's gonna keep doing that for me. So if you have one of these lying around or something of similar vintage from the early 2000s, I don't know, if you've got a little extra time one day and you feel like doing something a little bit different, pick it up, put one of those lenses on it, either an older lens or maybe even a more current lens that it'll still work with, and take it for a spin and see if it's as bad as you think it was, or if you're kind of surprised like me and it really delivered in a way that I didn't remember that it would. Thanks, everybody. Have a great day.